So in this three-part video series, we're going to discuss what a front-end developer is, what a back-end developer is, and also the pros and cons of each. So part one, today's video, is all about the front-end developer. Part two will be the back-end developer, a future video. And the video after that one, we're going to be talking about the pros and cons of each role and a little bit more information about how it would work and perhaps which one you should be focusing on. But let's start, though, with the definition of a front-end developer. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's Windows Presentation Foundation course. Master Windows Presentation Foundation, or WPF, and learn how to create applications with a rich user interface. Leverage WPF with C# and XAML to build real-world skills with Azure, REST, MVVM, and machine learning. Visit lpa.dev/YouTube WPF or click on the link in the description below. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. As I briefly mentioned, three-part video series. Today's video is all about a front-end developer. So what is a front-end developer? Well, that's a developer, a web developer, with a focus on what the user interacts with on a website. So they work with the web designer, but also they work with a back-end developer as well. And I'll talk more about that a little bit later. So the typical skills that a front-end developer would need would be HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So that would be sort of the three prerequisite skills you'd need, but there'd certainly be other things like jQuery and so on and so forth that you'd need to learn as well. Lots of other things which I won't go into detail now. Now, see the web designer versus a web developer video that I did previously. Click up here, and that outlines more information on what general web developer skills that you should be aware of. So check that if you need to. So getting back to the front-end developer though, they implement the web designer's user interface and basically get that working, if you will. Now, that's basically the look and feel of the website, but also they interact with the back-end process, if there is one, for a website. And these days, all but the most trivial or basic websites usually have some form of back-end or server process, you know, some sort of data storage or whatever it is. So to hopefully clarify this a little bit more, let's consider an example of a website. So here you can see the Learn Programming Academy's website. Now over to the right-hand side there, you can see that there's an image that looks, it's basically a book that you can click. There's a little link there you can click. It's an image of a book. And if you click on that, well, basically it'll take you to another page. So the front-end developer, they've implemented that website, and they've also added the functionality there so that once the button is clicked, in this case, the little image button there, it takes you to another page. So the front-end developer has basically added the code to do that. And that new page, if the user then clicks that button on that page, they've added that functionality as well. And you can see that what pops up is a little box there for the user to enter their email address. And once they've done that, once they've clicked on that button, the basically at that point, the information gets sent through to the back-end process on the server. And that then sends out the ebook. So the saving of the email address and sending of the email with a link to the user's email, basically their inbox, if you will, to download the ebook, that's a back-end process, and that's created by a back-end developer. Whereas the front-end developer, they're focused on the front-end, they're focused on the buttons and so forth, the clicks, so they've opened up a new page, and then what they've done is they've actually used the process given to them by a back-end developer, and they can access that functionality. In this case, the functionality was for the back-end process to accept that email address, and then they take that email address away, and then they start processing. So you can see where the front-end developer's role has finished is in sending the information. They don't know the implementation details of what's happening on the back-end, you know, how the email is actually sent out to someone, how the email was put together and sent out to the user. Basically, all they're doing is they've implemented the functionality in this particular example. So I go back to the first page, you've got the button on the screen there. I've clicked on that, it opens up the next page, if you will. And then after that, there's another button to click. It then pops up the form. You can see there, email address is typed in. Then the button is clicked to download the ebook. So after the download button is pressed, is the front-end developer's basically their responsibility. That's what they've implemented. They've then sent that using a special code API call, if you will, or a way to access that functionality from the back end. They've used that to send the information through to the back end process on the server, and that then basically kicks off and does the rest. So you can see how there's two separate roles here. There's the front end developer who's focusing on the look and feel on what the user is interacting with the website. Then there's the back end process, which we haven't seen in this example, where that accepts the email address and starts processing it. So basically there's a handoff process from the front end where it hands off the information that it's processed, in this case it's the email address, and sent it through to the back end, and that's the way basically it works. The front-end developer and the back-end developer may be the same developer, depending on whether you've been part of a large team or whether you're working for yourself. So I don't think you necessarily can't do both yourself. It is quite common in small development teams or even solo developers to have some skills at both as a front-end and a back-end developer. But certainly once you get out into industry and you start working with large teams, you'll see that the roles are often separated. So you've got front-end developers who focus just on the front-end, and you've got back-end developers who only focus on the back-end. And then there's basically a way that they can talk and interact with each other in some way. All right, so hopefully that's given you a bit of an understanding of what a front-end developer is. Tomorrow's video, as I mentioned, part two, we're going to talk about the role of a back-end developer. And then part three, the video that's coming out after that, I'm going to go through the pros and cons of both the front-end and back-end developer. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.